PA today.
No, you didn't get, you volunteered.
Well, he asked both of us very nicely.
Yeah, and I walked out.
How do you pronounce this name?
This is cheap paper. It has a different feel to it.
Pribilova?
Pribilova.
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 Terza Venisova. No, that's not too bad.
Venisova. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, the unlikely event of emergency or fire alarm activation, everyone must leave the building via the nearest exit. Please take note of exit doors at all four corners of the building. We remind you that smoking is not allowed inside the Winterboard Center. We ask you that you please refrain from cleaning on or pounding on glass at the drink center. Please refrain from any objects on the ice that you need to exit from the arena immediately. Fans are also required to stay alert during game. aroused to him. Profanity, racial or sexist comments, or other intimidating actions directed at officials, student athletes, coaches, team representatives, or other fans will not be tolerated and are grounds for removal from the Woodrow Center. Thank you for your cooperation.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Taos Rink at the Whittemore Center Arena for University of New Hampshire Hockey. Today, the Wildcats take on the Maine Black Bears. Now, for today's starting lineup, first for the Black Bears, at left and wing, number 28, Vendela Primilova. At center, number 17, Lydia Murray. At right wing, number 21, Teresa Vanasova. At defense, number 29, Kristen Gilmore. At defense, number 25, Nicole Arnold. And in net, number 33, Carly Jackson. The Black Bears are coached by Reichenbach with assistance coaches Sarah Reichenbach, Michael Grady, and Brooklyn Engwall. And now, let's meet the starters for your Wildcats. At right wing, number 20, Abby Chapman. At center, captain, Jonah Curtis. At right wing, number 26, Carly Tate. At defense, number 10, Amy Schlegel. At defense, number 21, Mary Jo Pelletier. In net, number 29, Hillary Cashman. UNH is coached by Hillary Wynn and associate head coach Stephanie Jones and assistant coach Bill Bates. Will everyone please rise for the singing of the national anthem, which will be performed by Annalise Merritt.
Officials today, head referee Benjamin Ward and Paul Crystal, linesman Rob Kelly and Jeff Cameron.
Well, just kidding with that. We are underway here from the Whittemore Center, UNH in Maine. Just underway here in women's ice hockey action. Game one of the doubleheader day. Women now, men coming up later on against Notre Dame. We'll get to the lines here in just a moment. Here come the Black Bears into the zone. Maine skating right to left. A shot that's redirected high and wide off the stick of Kripilova, and now out to the far side left. The Wildcats try to clear it along the far side half while Chapman over there for the Wildcats. Puck comes loose to Peltier. She tries to backhand it along. Bouncing puck just beyond the blue line. Wildcats have to pull back, and now angled up ice to feed too far behind Carly Tate. Headband feed up along the near side left. Here's Hutchison. Gets it over to the circle. Loose puck to the high slot. Walking her way in there is Motto. She sends one in, and there's a save made by Hillary Cashin. Out to the near wing, Peltier gets it further behind Schlegel. Outlet feed out to the far side left. And now here comes Turner. She'll lift it along the far wing. Off the boards, now off beyond the goal line extended. Wildcat left side of the ice into the zone. McManus comes along. Motto there as well, trying to take it away. Off the Wildcat forehand stick here of Turner. Back along the near point, up and out of the zone. Up along the far side right, here come the Black Bears into the Wildcat end. Top right circle. Wildcats try to strip it away. From behind over there, it was Dunbar. Maine comes away with it through the corner on the far wing. Down low on the near left circle, backed up to the point. Controlled at the point on the near side left by the Black Bears and by Cassara. Out to the far wing, Dunbar trying to play it along the far kick plate, back to center. Front of the Wildcat bench area, just beyond Fedeski. Maine's going to change up some legs here as the Wildcats chase it down to the corner here on the near side. Shoveled back through the center blue line, out to the far side left. Adler for the Wildcats, getting it to the corner out on the far side, and it's wrapped around to the near corner on the opposite right wing. Kripilova tries to play it along the near wing. Taylor fires it back on into the Maine zone. Just beyond 2 minutes here into this first period of play, scoreless. Kripilova here on the near left circle, through the line, and now back through center ice. Trying to pick her pocket there, and the streak ahead there was Taylor. Taylor tried to take it away, but for the Wildcats, there's Haslett to get it out to the far left side, angled along by Rowe, touched up along the far half wall, and the puck comes end over end back through neutral ice. Haslett looking to chase it down out on the far wing. Also over there, Lydia Murray for the Black Bears. About 2.5 minutes into the first period of play on Alumni Day here from the Whittemore Center. UNH coming into this one with a 8-game win mark here in conference play. With a win here today, the Wildcats move up in the conference standings, number 3. Up along the near side left. On the charge there was, for the Black Bears, Vinasova. Behind the net and around out through the corner on the far wing. Rowe trying to chase it down, and she angles it up ice. And here come the Wildcats, and the captain, Curtis, she sends one in. It goes wide. It grazed the left glove hand of the netminder in Carly Jackson. Taves off her stick, out to the far side right. Cleared back to center. Rob Daly, how you doing today, bud?
Well, Nate, Wildcats here. it's been a pretty wide open start to this one for both teams, really keeping the play along the boards, and neither team really with a lot of good looks offensively here as both teams getting their sea legs on mid-Saturday afternoon after playing a game at 7 o'clock last night. So could see fatigue be a factor here, especially early on as both teams look to get their skating legs going.
We get an icing call, 16 minutes and 18 seconds to go here in the first period. We are scoreless between UNH and Maine. UNH lines here, we'll run through them very quickly. Chapman, Curtis, Taves, Dunbar, McManus, and Turner. Prowse, Haslett, and Taylor. Two extra forwards rounding out the depth chart for the Wildcats, Radatovich and Tuzos. We'll see a few shifts from those two ladies here on the afternoon. Decor is going to be Schlegel with Peltier, Fedeski with Howren, Rowe with Revkin, and of course, Cashin between the pipes, backed up today by Kira Smith. Out to the far wing, Wildcats trying to clear it up and out of their far zone, up along the far side right, tapped up ahead by the Black Bears, played up ice along the far wing, there's Turner. Wildcats try to clear it along the near wing, but it's picked off by Maine, trying to walk their way in, opposite circle over on the far wing, they can't quite get a feed all the way through. Comes back through center, Dunbar trying to chase down, she is opposite Gilmore here as she plays it to the corner here on the left side of Jackson. Maine plays it with Gilmore now. Up headman feed up along the left side. Trying to walk it along here is Jakes. Wildcats play it away with Peltier out to the far side left. Now the Wildcats into the zone and a shot from atop the left circle. His glove down by Jackson, stopping play this time with 15:28 to go.
Yeah, Wildcats in the middle of a line change, looking to get quick offensive transition. Turner, fresh off the bench, had the puck at the top of the circle, let a wrister go. Jackson saw it coming in all the way, was able to make the easy save with the Wildcats with an offensive zone faceoff.
Far dot. Puck can't get all the way through the slot. Comes back up to the point. Backhanding it along there was Howren on the near wing. Kicked off by Motto. Motto now backhands it along into the New Hampshire zone. Plays it off the dasher to herself. through the circle, behind the net. Wildcats strip it away up along the far side left. Wildcats look to clear it up. Prowse up along the far wing, and now here's Taylor on the charge up ice. Blocker save made by Jackson. She steers it out to the corner on the right side of her. Out to the far wing. We are inside 15 minutes to go here in the first. Scoreless between the Wildcats and the Black Bears. Put a wrap on the season series here today. Taylor now through the corner on the far side. Finds a forehand stick of the Maine skater in Motto up along the near side left. Trying to chase down here is Catherine Tufts. Can't quite catch up to it. Icing will be whistled against the Black Bears. So Wildcats will get their first face-off here on an icing call back in the offensive end. 14:39 to go.
And Maine in this one has been aggressive offensively with the puck in their own. They've been able to get a couple looks in on Hillary Cashin from afar. Cashin has been solid in net ever since she's really won over the starting role, but you'd look for Maine to bounce back with a little bit better offensive performance this afternoon than what they came out with against New Hampshire last evening.
Valentin can't get it all the way through. Wildcats looking for a streaking Taves across the middle. Jonna tried to thread the needle across the middle, and now it comes back outside left hashes up to the point row. She wraps it behind the net. There's Taves. Taves tries to center it up, picked off by Motto. Looking up along the near side left, Tufts trying to lead the charge up ice through neutral. Comes back across the center line. She follows it up out to the far wing, but not for long offside the whistle. 14:07 to go here in the first period. We'll step aside. This is Wildcat Hockey from Learfield.
Sure.
Oh, okay. That never happens.
Mark the day and time.
Blame it on Jim. Shot from the point, hits the end wall, comes out to the corner on the far side. Maine trying to carry it along. Up along the left side, Cats on the takeaway. Jonna Curtis out to the far side left. Gets it to the top of the circle. Chapman tries to get one in front, followed up to the corner and broken up. Venezova there as well for the Black Bears. She comes out along the far side right, and Maine will clear it along. She walks back across neutral ice. She's met up over there with Pelletier. She now steers it backhand along the far side left. D-to-D, the Wildcats try to play. We'll check that. It's going to be Dunbar along the right side. With one arm, she steers it into the zone. McManus trying to chase it down here on the near corner. Motto getting a lot of ice time here. She tries to pinch the puck up against the kick plate behind Jackson. It comes behind the net further, and now Dunbar is going to try to chase down. Hutchison over there as well for the Black Bears as they look to clear up and out.
Yeah, Wildcats looking to get a little rush into the offensive zone, trying to break through, get behind this Maine defense, but Maine so far has been able to force the Wildcats to play along the boards and have really shut down any action in front of Carly Jackson.
Off the far kick plate, Wildcats come away with it in neutral. Here comes McManus looking across the middle, streaking up the far side left wing was Turner. Tried to backhand it along, couldn't get a full piece on it. Save made by Jackson up along the corner on the far side. Everyone loses sight of the puck. And we will get a whistle, a stoppage, and a face-off coming in the Maine zone with 12 minutes and 31 seconds to go here in the first.
Right, and that was a nifty shot by Carly Turner as Nicole Dunbar let the backhander go from the right wing, and it basically bounced through the slot to the right side, or to the left side, excuse me, and Turner was able to corral the puck in a bounce and get the shot in on Jackson.
On the face-off, Fedeski trying to get a shot all the way through. It comes back to center. Wildcats from center send it along here with Howren to the circle on her opposite right side. Angled off the far, end wall rather, out to the far side wing. Cats pick it off in neutral again. Howren tries to lift it along in front of the penalty boxes on the far wing. Taylor carries it along outside left circle. She gets taken down on the carry ahead. Out to the far wing. Colton tries to play it along out to the corner on the far side. Wildcats come away with it. Hazlett camping out right in front of the netminder for the Black Bears in Jackson. Finds its way in towards her glove hand. She'll hold on for the stop. 11:52 to go, scoreless.
Wildcats getting a little bit more momentum on the offensive side. Have been able to get a little bit of a weave going offensively, and that time the puck's brought back out to the dot. Again, a shot sent the way of Jackson. No traffic in front. Wildcats, although working the puck in the offensive zone, not getting anyone in front of the Maine goal, and that's going to be a focus here as they looked for the first goal of the afternoon.
Up to the point. Maine carries it along. A delayed call here coming against the Wildcats. Through the circle on the far wing. Loose puck comes to the high slot. Backhanded along here. Back up to the point now. Gilmore gets it out to the right side. Blocked out. Gilmore now carries it along the left point again. Plays it further along through the near corner. Wildcats touch it up here along the near wing, courtesy of Taves. So a power play coming up here for the Black Bears. 11:26 to go. First special teams opportunity for either team on the afternoon. It's going to be Chapman.
Yep, Chapman going off 2 minutes for interference as Maine was breaking out in the neutral zone in front of the dot, in front of the Maine bench. Chapman just stepped out and sort of picked off the Maine forward. So the Black Bears are going to get their first opportunity of the game. 9 power play goals on the season for the Black Bears, 11% for Maine.
PK for the Wildcats on the season. They've killed off 94 of 109, good enough for 86.2 on the kill rate. And we got a faceoff coming back into neutral ice as 3 seconds elapsed off of the game clock on a puck that was redirected into the crowd. So the faceoff will come in the neutral zone, near dot to us. Peltier, Hazlitt, Rowe, and Taylor, the killers out there for the Wildcats. Inside 11 and a half to go here in the first period. 0-0 is our tally so far. Hummel now back across center. Pribilova here along the near left circle. Looking to drop it back to the point. Played there once again by Hummel on the left side. Along the near wing, Murray gets it back up to the point. Hummel gets it out to the far side right. Motto over there for the Black Bears. Holds it in on the right point. Tries to get it to the corner on the far wing. Back up to the top circle, and Hazlitt gets a piece of it and guides it back to neutral ice.
They actually tried to send the length of the ice, and then it got blocked, but the Wildcats maintained possession and finally able to dump it in with Taylor.
Nice job by Taylor there on the takeaway. Big bounce off the corner. Wildcats trying to send John up to try to clean it up between the circles. Maine will pull back deeper into their own zone. Motto plays directly behind Jackson now as we have 1 minute to play here on this early power play for the Black Bears. Stacy, along the near side left, gets it into the zone. Carries it along, looking to the corner on the stick side right of Hillary Cashin. Out to the opposite corner, back up to the right point. Controlled here by Gilmore. She takes a slapper. It's gloved down in front by the Wildcats. Backhanded along by Curtis. And a little bit of help there from the point, and Taves gets it back to neutral ice. This one tipped back to the main bench, or onto the main bench, and a faceoff will come in neutral ice with now 37 to go on the power play. About 10 minutes to go here in the first period.
As the season has gone on, Nate, the Wildcats have improved drastically on the penalty kill. They've done a real nice job shutting down the shooting lanes, and they've been a lot more aggressive, you know, really holding their defensive blue line on the forecheck and trying to break offensively. And that's something we haven't seen here from this team in a couple of years, is the aggression on the penalty kill.
Cleared back by the Wildcats again, just out of the reach here of Hummel. Tried to kick it away with her right skate to try to cradle it down, and instead comes all the way back behind her own net, up along the near side left now, Murray. Murray into the zone along the left side, tries to drop it back. There to play is Vinasova, looking behind the net, she carries it along. Cycles it out to the far side circle, and now a feed back up to the point is cleared back. Couldn't quite handle the feed there was Motto, and now all the way back into the main zone. Wildcats, McManus trying to take it away. And up into the main bench again, this time stopping play with 9.5 to go, 5 ticks to go on the Wildcats PK.
And Maine had good possession in the offensive zone, and Vinasova just fired the puck at her defenseman, just sent it flying by her. So Maine need to be a little bit more careful holding on to that puck, and they can move it slowly. They had plenty of space to work the puck.
Short-handed bid here for the Wildcats as Taylor tried to thread one in front to Hazlitt. UNH gets back to full strength, killing off one of one here in the early goings of this one. 0-0 our score. Prowse tries to steer it along. Comes out loose out to the far wing. Brigham over there for the Black Bears. Bouncing pass. Handcuffed there was the Black Bears in Jakes as well. She tries to tap it up along for a streaking Brigham along the near side left. Looking on the circle. Blocked down by the Cats in front. Peltier trying to jam it home there. The Black Bears. Puck just in front of Cashin, and it squirts out to the corner to the far wing. Wildcats and Taylor trying to guide it along the far wall to get it up and out of the zone. Bouncing puck to the point. Kicked in by the Black Bears over on the far wing. You know, it's going to be controlled by the Cats behind their own net.
Yeah, Maine with probably the best scoring look of the afternoon so far. They were able to work the puck down low in front of Cashin, but the Wildcats sent 3 white jerseys in there to quickly break it up.
Tufts on a drive out to the corner now on the far side. She had all kinds of room up along the right wing. Kept in along the near side left here by Cassidy Herman. Back to the top of the circle here on the near wing. Back up to the point now. A shot blocked down by the Cats. Hazlitt doing everything she can to clear it back to center. Wildcats with a little bit of help from Prowse over on the far line. Gets it back to neutral ice. Wildcats will have to chase down behind at Cashin again.
Yeah, that was almost a dangerous change there by the Cats, but they needed it with those three forwards.
Here comes Jonna out along the far left side, tries to get it across for Tuzos. So when we do see Radatovich and Tuzos out there, it looks like Jonna's going to be the third skater out there. Jonna will center up that line. First touches of the afternoon for Radatovich and Tuzos for the Wildcats. Puck finds a stick over on the far wing of Gilmore. Bouncing puck back to neutral ice. Wildcats have to come back and touch up the line. Taken away here by Teresa Vinasova. Blew the circle on the near side, a centering feed. Couldn't quite get it across for Lydia Murray, who was skating right up the middle. And on that centering bit, it comes back into the Maine zone. Remember, Maine skating right to left here. They've controlled the pace of play, if you will, early in this one. And now the Wildcats will take control here with McManus into the zone along the right wall. She gets pinched off against the wall by Motta behind the net. Motta tries to carry it along. Kept in at the point there by the Cats and Howard. She blasts one wide, and now here's McManus. Through Turner out to the far wing. Trying to chase down as Howard over to the far wing. Howard 5'9 out of Bancroft, Ontario. Five helpers on the year. As she is flanked on the right with Fedeski. Loose puck over on the corner, though, on the right side of Jackson. And it's finally moved along Dunbar now through the circle on the far wing. She'll now pivot and retreat further back to the corner. Behind the net. Comes out loose in front of Jackson. The Black Bears lifted along back through center, though. Bouncing puck all the way back into the New Hampshire zone.
Yeah, Wildcats have had a couple opportunities to work the puck behind the main net. And each time they've tried to get the puck out in front, there hasn't been a white jersey anywhere to be found to get a good look in on the main net.
Howard trying to lift it along the far glass. Neutral ice play right now. Carry it along the near side left by the Black Bears. Hutchison now on the carry. Wildcats now on the takeaway with Fedeski and some help along the far wing from Chapman. Out along the far side left. Big angled up feed up ice. Curtis. Curtis trying to play it from Taves. Jonna got tangled up with the linesman over on the far side. To the corner on the near wing. Taken away by the Black Bears. And now they'll walk it back along the near side left through neutral. And here Washer will send it along further. Washer with that goal yesterday for the Black Bears. The one goal for Maine on the afternoon yesterday. A 4-1 win for the Wildcats. And an icing call will be whistled here against UNH. We'll step aside. 5:32 to go here in the first. This is Wildcat Hockey from Learfield.
Here going to look to set up. They've gone at times this year with three defensemen on the power play, and it's been effective for them. We'll see what they throw out here for this first power play of the day.
Just past the 15-minute mark here of the first period, scoreless. Back to neutral ice we play up along the near side right. Here's McManus. Wildcats on the Unitil power play now for the next 1 minute and 27 seconds. Wildcats and Howard, big feed up to the far side left. Wildcats try to creep along with the puck to the top of the circle. Howard on the feed. Over from the far side left and Turner out to the corner on the far side. Wildcats work the left side of the ice. Here's Howard at the point. She sends one in, kicked aside by Jackson. Follow-up opportunity sails wide off the stick of Turner. Cleared back by the Black Bears to the other end of the ice. Lydia Murray on the clear. Looking to the corner on the near wing, Fideski losing a stick there was Cashin, but the Wildcats clean up the puck. They clean up possession, and they get it back to center.
Yeah, Wildcats were able to get a good setup off of Howard, and she got a shot, and then the rebound to Turner.
Jonna gets a shot off, kicked away again by Jackson, up along the near corner, controlled for a moment by Taves, cleared along the half wall. There's Schlegel. Schlegel with a seam there, trying to send one in. She does so, but it's up into the sweater of Jackson, stopping play with 35 ticks to go on the Unitil power play, inside four to go on the first period game clock.
That little flurry set up originally by Curtis. Curtis pulled the puck out from the left wing boards, brought it, got the shot off from the slot. Maine was trying to clear the puck. Schlegel was able to keep it in, though, with a shot through a screen in front of the Maine goaltender. But Jackson faces her first tough shot of the day and is able to make the save easily.
Cleared back through the corner glass. Tufts couldn't control, so the Wildcats will play now with Peltier on her own center blue line. Wildcats retreat back with Jonna Curtis. Out to the far side left, Wildcats jump the gun. Barely out on the far side left, so now 18 to go on the power play.
Yeah, Taves brought her skate into the zone before the puck was there. Easy call for the linesman at the opposite side of the ice, but definitely picked that up a little too quick as the pass was slowly getting over to Carly.
Benjamin Lord and Paul Driscoll are referees on the lines. Rob Kelly and Jenny Cameron. So this the first power play of the game for the Wildcats. Maine already 0 of 1. Peltier will play it behind Cashin, but now only 7 ticks to go here on the UNH power play. Carried along the far side left, back through center. Schlegel gets hit up against the wall on the far side, lost an edge, and now the Black Bears will play it out to the corner on the near side left, looking for a big blue line feed, a home run feed up along the left wing there with Venezova. The Wildcats have something to say about that, and they'll send it back on into the Maine zone. Venezova out on the far wing. She controls the puck through her far right circle, through neutral. It's taken away there by Hazlitt. Inside three to go as Hazlitt tried to get it over for Taylor, who is skating up the middle. Up along the near corner, through the corner. Stacy tries to control, take away Taylor. Taylor now trying to send one along. Lost an edge. She got the shot off from her knees as she went sliding from pretty much the top of the circle to the hashes. And now out in the opposite corner on the far side, left wing for the Wildcats, pinched up against the wall, and now it squirts through the corner, and the Wildcats will play it back along with Prowse.
A lot of pin pucks along the boards here in this first period. Both teams really playing along the wall and really slowing down the pace of this game, and there haven't even been a lot of whistles in the first period.
Funny bounce on a centering bid there. The Black Bears tried to get it along to the left D.
Yeah, Maine a couple times has had a hard time holding on to the puck behind their net, and this time the puck trickled out from behind the boards. It just went off of Jackson. She wasn't even expecting it. And then the Wildcat forwards came in there, Kate Hasslett and Allie Prowse, both battling in front of the main net, but Jackson able to fall on the puck and force a faceoff.
Arnold tried to get it over for Gilmore in front, but it found its way in towards Jackson. Black Bears on the faceoff win in their own zone, get it back to center. Hutchinson tries to carry it along the near side left. Help from the Wildcats, McManus. Dunbar there as well, trying to play it along the near side right. McManus now trying to play to the corner here on the glove side left of Jackson. Inside two to go here in the first period. And again, some more play up against the wall as Turner comes away with it. Tries to get a centering feed up for a streaking Howren, who is working her way in from the point. Fideski trying to chase down. Yep.
There's been about probably like 6 or 7 instances in this period where the puck's been pinned along the boards for 10 seconds or more, and you'd figure at some point the referees would start blowing the whistle, but they've let both teams do it so far.
Dunbar trying to center it up just in front of the net there with McManus. Comes out through the corner on the near side left for the Black Bears. We're approaching a minute to play here in this first period. A fast-moving first period of play with Taves now into the offensive zone through the left circle. Now to the corner. Looking behind the net, trying to get one in front. No one there as Jonna was at the high slot area. Taves will come away with it again. Gets it back over for Curtis. On the follow-up, Chapman there trying to wind up and send it home. Fanned on the opportunity. Peltier crashing the near side left, right corner rather, trying to play the puck up ice for Chapman. Comes back through the corner on the opposite side, and now the Black Bears try to lift it along. All the help over there from Brigham back to center. Nice job by the Wildcats here on the near side. Peltier getting a stick on it. Venezova now trying to split the defenders on her way in through the circle. Cashin covering up the gliding puck. Not much energy on that one as it's found its way towards her. but she'll get the whistle when we stop play with 26.4 to go.
Yeah, Vinasova made a nice little deke at the top of the circle around two Wildcat defensemen and then slipped the puck down to Pribilova, but just she couldn't get her full stick on the puck, and Cashin was able to get her glove on it.
Faceoff win for the Cats, and now here's Prowse up along the far side left, opposite wing feed here, up ice with Hazlitt. Hazlitt trying to play the puck. She loses an edge. Taylor there as well on the near corner. Comes across the middle. Too far in front of Prowse. Now kept in by Peltier. Top left circle. Taken away by the Black Bears as they clear it back to center. Five to go in the period. Backhanded along by the Cats along the near side right. Schlegel tried to send it along. It finds its way in towards Jackson as the horn sounds on period number one. Two breaks to take care of. Let's take care of one of them right now. 0-0 UNH and Maine. From Learfield, this is Wildcat Hockey.
It's the end of the first period. Shots on goal, 5 for Maine, 6 for UNH. Ladies and gentlemen, please direct your attention to our home bench as we recognize the trailblazers of the UNH Women's Ice Hockey Program. The efforts to establish a women's ice hockey program at UNH began in the 1970s when a group of women petitioned to the campus recreation office to accomplish their goal of forming a recognized team. The petition made its way to the vice president for student affairs, at which point the team was granted club sports status with access to ice time equipment from the intramural office. 1 year later, the director of club sports compelled the director of women's athletics to promote the program to a full-time varsity status. And from 1977 to 1978, UNH women's hockey team played their first official 15-game schedule. The team was among the first 11 varsity athletic women's ice hockey programs in the nation, and it performed at a high level, winning 6 championship titles during the next decade. We recognize that the UNH Women's Ice Hockey Program would not be what it is today without the tenacity and spirit of these talented women. We ask that you please join us in recognizing our UNH Women's Ice Hockey Trail Blazers. Linda Mariano, Karen Bodwell, Melissa White Willis, Wendy Larson, Donna Nystrom Martineau, Gabrielle Lee's Pato, Bonnie Boyd, Kathy Bryant, Cindy Eaton, Diane Langus Gray, Lynn Walsh, Deb Cunningham, Carol Fisher Lowenstein, Kim Porter, Lori Hutchinson Ogilvie, Robin Balducci, Vivian Mary Gilbert, Dawn Wright Lucas, and Liz Tora Laza. We'd also like to acknowledge the other UNH Women's Hockey alumni who have joined us today and thank them for continuing to blaze the trail for the next few decades. The alumni include Liz Neely, Stephanie Jones, Jennifer Hitchcock, Sarah Becky, Carolyn Sawyer, Trina Bourdain Cassidy, Kristen Thomas, Michelle Gordon Lucier, Jen Hardin, Shannon Sisk, Raylan Zigalewski, Brittany Redlick, Sabrina Munson, Mary Marin, Sam Faber, Michaela Lama, Stephanie Holmes, Kelly Souza, Lisa Bennett, and Lisa Skian. Ladies, thank you for your dedication, commitment, and accomplishments during your time at UNH. Fans, join us in a round of applause as we welcome and thank our UNH Wildcats.
games.
Yeah, but that's true. That's true. Good point. We didn't actually play women's hockey.
No,
though.
No, but, you know, you don't. In the main zone as we blabber away. I mean, Rob and myself, that's a dinner out with friends because many of our alumni day nonetheless, and58th all-time meeting here between these two squads. Wildcats with a big advantage over the years here, 20-5. The Wildcats against Maine here, and a penalty coming up here against Maine as the Wildcats and Schlegel was pushed up against the wall. A boarding call, Rob?
Yeah, Teresa Venisova is going to go off. Boarding slash body checking will be the call. So the Wildcats here, just a little over a minute into the second period, will get their second power play opportunity of the afternoon as a top scorer for Maine will go off to the penalty boxes. That was just sort of a, you know, both players with a little effort there. Schlegel was skating hard after the puck, and so was Vanasova, but she just got a little bump right in front of the officials. Easy call, and the Wildcats with an opportunity as both teams strive for the first goal of the afternoon.
We'll redrop the faceoff. We don't want to forget about Aaron Boss back at WGIR as well, producing today's broadcast. Big day for Aaron with women's hockey and men's hockey. What a better, can't have a fine, think of a better way. Think of our Waster Saturday with myself, Murph, and Rob, and Pete. No comment from back in the studio. Unitil face-off, Unitil power play here as the Wildcats try to keep it in here. Pinch in along the near half wall. Unitil power play, Unitil energy for life. Videski tries to wrap it around to the opposite wing along the far side right. There's Dunbar outside right circle. Through the hash marks, tries to drop it off along the far wing for McManus. McManus will now give it further to the corner on the far wing. Dunbar now trying to get it behind the net, trying to get out to Turner here on the near side left. Behind the net again, McManus trying to send one in front, broken up by the Black Bears. Cleared back to the point, but not up and out. Top of the right circle, bouncing pass in front, kicked along. Videski tried to get it along further to the goal line extended, comes behind the net now. Wildcats try to send one in, they do so. Jackson with the initial stop. Puck squirts out to the corner on the near side, or far side rather. Stacy tries to clear it up and out, and they do so back to center. Howren, Schlegel, right blue line, sends a wrister in wide. Out to the corner on the near wing. Another penalty coming up here. This one will go against UNH. Hazlett trying to touch it up, and she does so. So that's going to do it for second power play opportunity for the Wildcats. They have 43 ticks to go on that first power play, and now it's Schlegel going to be going off for two for New Hampshire.
Yeah, Schlegel going to get called for tripping as the puck was on the near side boards in the Wildcat offensive zone, and Schlegel was skating in hard towards the puck, and she got beat to the puck by the main defender, and she went down to the ice. Easy call there for the officials, so we'll have 4-on-4 play for the next 40 seconds or so, and then Maine will get their second power play opportunity of the afternoon.
Wildcats try to play it back to center. Backhanding it along there was Taves. Pivoting back across neutral ice there for the Black Bears was Murray. Out to the corner on the near wing, Taves and Peltier there trying to take it away for the Wildcats. Peltier wins the battle, comes out along the far circle, gets it up ice for Curtis. Curtis now along the far side right neutral, skates into the zone. 4-on-4 for the next 13 seconds. Out to the corner on the far wing, Gilmore was there for the Black Bears. Taken away by Mame, comes back to the opposite wing on the near side right. Up ice, here's Colton, centering feed to Gilmore. Beyond her skate, Wildcat out of the box, cleared back up the length of the ice. And now it's played back here by the Black Bears. Check that, there was a change there with Hazlett. Out to the far side left, Maine now on the power play for the next 1:03. Angled off the near half wall, chased down here by Howren. Try to get it over for Fedeski, taken away by the Black Bears. Stacy gets it along to the point on the far side left. Shovel along from the point out to the far wing by Motto. Taken back by the Wildcats, and Hazlitt will lift it along through neutral.
Yeah, Wildcats quick to jump on the puck as Maine just dumping it in, but the Wildcats are beating Maine to the loose pucks and just clearing it out as they have 37 seconds left on the kill.
Vinasova trying to get it to the center line, broken up. There's Stacy to play it on the Wildcat logo at center. Inside 16 to go, inside 30 to go here on the power play for the Black Bears, and a tip off the stick of a Wildcat. 27 to go here on the power play for the Black Bears, still awaiting a tally with 15:52 to go.
Yeah, Peltier took out Teresa Vinasova in center ice, got sort of the hip into her, and she went flying. Vinasova, the leading scorer for this Maine team as a freshman, 15 goals and 11 assists for 26 points, a very impressive player for the Black Bears, but the Wildcats have done a nice job to this point keeping her quiet in the offensive zone today.
Peltier dances behind the net, gets it around through the corner, through Curtis as well. Chased down here into the offensive zone by the Cats. Here's Taves trying to send one along the pipe on the near side. 12 to go on the power play for the Black Bears.
Yeah, Taves had a chance to pull that puck in front of the Jackson net, but Matteau able to bump her out of the way at the last minute and just get the shot off the apron.
Here's Tufts outside right circle. Power play comes to an end. 5-on-5 as the Wildcats get back to full strength. Wildcats try to steer it up and out of the zone with Peltier out along the right side, right neutral. Hops off the stick there of the Wildcat skater up ice, and now up along the near side right. Here come the Black Bears into the zone, not for long on the offside. 15:08 to go here in the second period. We'll step aside, scoreless. Here from the Wit, this is Wildcat Hockey from Learfield. Corner, here's Taylor. Taylor now tries to get it along further for Prowse. Also there is Hazlitt behind the main net, wrapped around through the near corner. Up to the point, Schlegel keeps it in, lifted along through the near corner again, up to the opposite end. Hazlitt couldn't quite handle, comes out to the Black Bears, who try to angle it along out to the far wing. Pinched off against the wall there. Prowse, Hazlitt, a little trailer help there from Lydia Murray, comes back to the point. Blast in front there, Peltier couldn't quite get it all the way through. Nicole Arnold there on the block shot. Back up to the point again, sent in to Jackson. And she gloves it down on the initial shot from Peltier. 13:11 to go here in the second.
One of the best offensive flurries of the day for the Wildcats is they're able to finally get the cycle going in the offensive zone and they're able to generate three or four shots on Carly Jackson. She's able to make the saves. The Wildcats get good shots, but most of them coming from the perimeter. Wildcats trying to work some bodies in front of the main net, but Maine defensively has been able to clear out the Wildcats to this point.
Here's Rowe with a shot off the back kick plate. Kick cleaned up by Curtis. Jonna sends it in. Quick snapper there, blocked down by Jackson. Comes out through the corner up to the point.
And just like that, a lot of traffic in front of Jackson as Curtis had the nifty wrister from the top of the circle.
Rowe trying to play the loose puck here on the near wing. So too Stacy. So too Taves. Colton now plays it out to the far left side, and Maine will clear it back to center. Here comes Tufts into the zone, offside, well offside on the right side for the Black Bears was Sekundiak. 12:33 to go. UNH like to thank State Farm Insurance agents Renee LeClaire and Tony LeClaire for their continued support. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. Face off over on the far neutral zone. 12:32 to go here in the second period. Maine with a drive just wide on the far pipe. Coming back out to the circle on the far side. Maine trying to backhand it further along. Nice job there by the Black Bears and Hutchison trying to make something out of nothing. She had two white sweaters draped all over, and she got a quick shot off that went in wide on the near side. Comes back out to the far hashes. Wildcats trying to steer it along. They get it back to the point, but not up and out. Wildcats and Fedeski try to play a bouncing puck back to the point and up and out of the zone as well. Can't quite get it across. Hutchison tries to force a shot in. Motto there to control. Back up to the point. Rister sails high and wide. This one off the stick of Valton. And now it's going to be cleared back along the right side by the blue and white. Lifted along Fedeski. Tries to chase down the puck to the corner on the far side. Radatovich there alongside Tuzos behind the net. Tuzos can't control. Comes out along the near wing. Kept in there by the Cats on the clearance bid. McManus tries to get it further along. Radatovich now trying to thread the needle in front. Snaps a pass off to a streaking Dunbar up along the right side. Delayed call coming up here against Maine. Extra skater out there for the Cats. Shot from the point, redirects wide. Schlegel with the bid, and not really sure why we got the whistle. There was really no control there, but power play coming up for the Wildcats. We'll step aside. 11:16 to go here in the second. Scoreless from the Wit. This is Wildcat Hockey from Learfield. Why was that whistle?
I don't know. It was sort of just bouncing around.
Why is it coming in neutral ice? Okay. Wildcats on the power play. Nice shot by Schlegel down low on the far circle. Save made by Jackson. Just 18 seconds here into this Unitil power play. Valton goes off for two.
Yeah, Wildcats win the faceoff, and they're able to work the puck to the point. Taves with a cross-ice pass through the goal mouth to Schlegel, and Schlegel from point-blank range gets a shot in on Jackson. Jackson coming over and getting the left skate on it to keep it out of the net just at the last second for Maine.
So this is a Unitil power play, Unitil energy for life. Peltier keeps it on the left point. Scoreless between the Wildcats and the Black Bears. Stacy clears it back to the UNH end. We have now 1:28 to go on the power play. Behind the net and around. Wildcats play with Curtis. Sends it out to the opposite wing on the far side right. Sent in from the right blue line. And now a big bounce off the end wall comes onto this forehand stick of Curtis. Peltier, Curtis here on the near side left. Back up to the point, Peltier gets it out to the far side right. Slapshot bid there, blocked down off the stick of Schlegel. 1 minute to go on the Unitil power play, and now here's Curtis at the point. Chris crosses with Peltier, drop back past Peltier. Tries to get it down low for Schlegel, cleared back to and through the point. 10 minutes deep here into the second, halfway through regulation. And now 46 to go on the Unitil power play.
Peltier was trying to get fancy with the little shot pass to Schlegel down on the right post of the net, but two main defenders in the way are easily able to knock it away.
Schlegel out to the far side right. McManus tries to carry it along. Also over there on the far wing, Dunbar just ahead of her. Can't handle the feed, and now it comes back to the UNH end of the ice. Another clear for UMaine.
Yeah, this power play got off to a good start for New Hampshire. They were able to move the puck well defensively to set up some shots for their forwards, but trying to get maybe a little too fancy, and that's cost the Wildcats and allowed Maine to easily clear the puck a couple times.
Ouch, McManus again through the far line. Comes back to Howerin on the left point. She sends a shot wide. Played by the Black Bears over on the far wing. Cleared up and out of the zone courtesy of Brittany Colton. Wildcats trying to chase it down, and we will play with the Wildcats here with Fedeski. Julia really didn't look like she had really an awareness of where she was. She had a Maine skater streaking up ice to try to take the puck away. And in doing so, with that lackadaisical play, she's going to go off for interference.
Well, Fedeski was looking over her right shoulder. She was looking to see where to play the puck. It didn't realize that Catherine Tufts was streaking up the left wing to play and sort of skated by her. I didn't see a lot of body contact. Tufts fell down, but the falling down of Tufts, I guess, was enough to get an interference call. So seems like every time the Wildcats get a penalty, Maine gets one right after. So now Maine on their third power play after of the afternoon.
Well, the interference doesn't have to be exactly contact either.
Right.
I mean, it
right.
can be just be, you know, obstruction trying to get to the puck. So now Maine on the power play as Motto plays outside right circle. Motto sends one in through a tip. Comes out wide, or redirects out to the corner, rather, on that tip. Would have been a high stick anyway off the stick there of Venezova.
Yeah, it looked like it was well above the crossbar there, but and the official had his hand up in the air for a high stick as well.
Wildcats clear it back to neutral. 1 minute and 17 seconds to go here on the kill. Taylor now trying to get one in front. Peltier there as well for New Hampshire. Peltier out to the corner on the far wing. Tries to get it further along to Taylor. Maine comes away with it, looking for a big home run feed. Broken up there by the Cats in row. Trying to slap her stick onto the ice there was Sekundiak, because she wanted it on the center line.
And Sekundiak was almost able to take that away, as it almost went right through the five hole of Rowe, but Curtis was coming back to break it up as well.
Left point takeaway there by Curtis. She gets met up head on over there with Pripilova over on the far line. And now Maine will come back and play behind their own net, and Stacy up along the far side left will get it back to neutral.
The Wildcats being real aggressive, Taves and Curtis both up on the forecheck. Curtis almost looks like Sam Faber when she used to kill power plays as well, way up into the defensive zone trying to force that offensive turnover.
Curtis and Motto meet head-on right there as Howard tries to clear it up and out of the zone. Instead, Tufts keeps it in. On the corner on the glove side left of Hillary Cashin, shoveled along by the Wildcats, and Curtis comes all the way back. Just to the left of Jackson, she'll come out to play with 10 to go on the power play for Maine.
On Alumni Day, you knew I had to get at least one comparison in, Nate.
That's right. They're gonna keep flowing here into the third period. I can feel it. Out to the far side left, lifted along. Bouncing puck sticked away there by Cashin on an innocent send-ahead from center. Wildcats get back to full strength. We have 7 minutes to play, the 13-minute mark of the second period. Scoreless here between Maine and New Hampshire. Pivoting here, Venezova looking to steer her way in. Broken up by the Cats. Out to the far side wall. Played over there by the Wildcats and Dunbar. Dunbar back to center. Cowan couldn't quite get the clear. Now it's taken away. Here come the Black Bears. Trying to backhand her way in. A kick save made by Cashin. A follow-up bid and a save made by Cashin again. And loose puck comes out to the far wing. No whistle as it comes out behind the net. And now Maine comes away with it. Here's a wrister, and it's blocked down off the stick of Sakura. Now it's going to be cleared back the length of the ice. Cashin lost her stick.
She lost her
glove.
Yeah, she lost
her blocker. And now it comes back to the opposite corner on the far wing in the Maine zone. Wildcats and Prowse try to play.
She lost everything, and I don't know how the puck didn't go in the net there. She was in the net. She made the initial save, and as she was in the net, she had her skate up against the goalpost and was able to make two more saves, and then the puck just disappeared.
Circle on the near wing, back up to the point, broken up. Cats get caught again. 2-on-1 developing for Maine up along the far side left. Here they come into the zone, sending it wide on the drive in front. There was Jakes. Wildcats come away with it on the circle. Here comes Taylor back across center, out to the far side right into the zone. She lost the puck in transition, and now it's going to be played by the Black Bears further behind. And now here's Colton up along the near side right, gets through Brigham. Trying to streak up to it here is Stacy. Nice burst of speed there by the defenseman out to the far wing. Wildcats get it through the corner, now through center. Wildcats skate with it into the zone. Here comes Curtis. Jonna trying to use her speed out to the far wing. Played to the corner now by New Hampshire. Behind the net, Taves. Taves couldn't quite handle. Stacy seems to be everywhere out on the ice here during the second period. Nice play by Brooke Stacy, the three sweater for Maine. Played back to Peltier at center. Outlet pass out to the far side right. Here's Curtis. Jonna trying to send a wrister in. It's blocked down. Wildcats still have possession in the offensive zone with inside five to go. Here's a wrister from the point. Behind the net now. And a no goal. Didn't quite get all the way through. Here's Peltier now trying to send a wrister in. Jackson overskated the save. And we have a whistle and a hand pass behind the play.
Are they going to take a look at this again? I mean, it looked very possible that the puck went into the net, so the officials coming over the scores table, I would assume they're going to take a look, as it looked like the puck might have trickled in, as it was sort of an awkward play. The puck was behind the net. The Cats went to play it out in front. It might have gone in off the back leg of Johnson.
4:42 to go here in the second period. Call on the ice is a hand pass and a faceoff coming at neutral, but they were reviewing a no-goal call just a moment ago. We'll step aside as the officials sort it out down in the penalty box area. Scoreless between Maine and New Hampshire. This is Wildcat Hockey from Learfield. Looks like the game clock is going to be at 4:40, 44 minutes and 44 seconds. No. 4 minutes. So Chapman gets credit with a goal, second goal of her career for the freshman from Beverly Hills, Michigan. And upon the review, that was more point blank,
yeah,
cut and dry.
It was a little bit bang bang as Maine cleared the puck out of there really quickly, so you could see where the official might not see it right away as we're still trying to get the clock fixed. But nice play there, Abby Chapman. You know, when you get that puck behind the net, you just throw it at the goaltender and see what happens. Try to surprise her. Went off the back of Jackson, but came back to Chapman, and she was able just to poke it right in.
So fans, you missed it at home, but once again, it was EnviroVantage to the rescue with their traditional fish abatement after the first goal by the Wildcats. Serving New England for over 25 years, EnviroVantage is your one-stop resource for environmental cleanup and is proud to be an official partner of Wildcat Sports. Visit EnviroVantage.com to learn more. Wildcats up 1-0 again on that Chapman goal. And we get a face-off here at center.
I think that goal will probably end up being unassisted, but we'll see once we get the official score.
First goal of the game yesterday for the Wildcats came early in the second period. Now late in the second period today, Wildcats up 1-0. Out to the far corner on the far wing. Maine in the New Hampshire zone, inside 4.5. Now to play here in the second period as Cats skate away with it behind their netminder and Cashin. Up along the near side left, Turner now angles it along. Trying to get it up ice for McManus. McManus on the chase down on the corner. McManus looking further ahead. Comes back along the corner on the near wing. McManus trying to play up along the near half wall. She gets pinched off there with Lydia Murray and a quick whistle there on the frozen puck. And we'll get a faceoff coming on the near dot in the Maine zone to the left side of us with now 4:07 to go.
Boy, that puck wasn't frozen up against the boards for a second when the referee blew the whistle when they've let that go for most of the afternoon. But all of a sudden, the official says, all right, we're not doing it anymore. We'll blow that whistle.
Benjamin Lord blows the whistle quickly. Paul Driscoll, not so much. Back to the high slot area. Fedeski couldn't get a shot off. Cats force it behind the net along the near wing. 16-minute mark of the second period of play. Wildcats up 1-0 on the second goal of the season, 15-16 mark, courtesy of Abby Chapman. Up along the far side left, Cats come away with it. Check that, Black Bears come away with it to the corner on the far side, and now out to the near side wing. Sekundiak trying to clear it along. Wildcats and Prowse trying to lift it along as well, up along to the near corner. Brooke Stacy there on the takeaway for Maine. Back to the neutral ice, and now Wildcats on the chase down out to the far wing. To the corner now, and the Wildcats, Fedeski out to the near side left. Lifted along, back along the near side left, Prowse. Prowse along the left side, lifting it through Hazlitt. Out of the cage to play there is Jackson. 3 minutes and 14 seconds to go here in the second. Back into the neutral zone, and Brigham tries to play it up into the New Hampshire zone. Cats flip it up into the air, courtesy of Chapman back through center. Here's Curtis. Curtis now trying to split the decor. Sends one in and she scores. What a shot by Jonna Curtis. Snaps off a wrister. As she was going to the opposite circle, and it is now a 2-0 game.
Boy, what a nifty play by Curtis, as there were two Black Bear defenders between her and the net. She splits them and basically jumped off the ice between them, and as she jumped between them, she let her wrister go and beat Jackson to the stick side right. So the Wildcats, late in period number two, extend their lead to 2-0 on now the 14th goal of the season for Curtis, and she creeps ever so closer to that 100-point mark.
Inside 3 minutes to go, Wildcats up 2-0, up along the far side right. Here come the Cats again, up along the left side. Chapman wanted it up along the left wing. Try to gather some daylight there as she was skating up along the side. Kisara up along the far side right. Wildcats can't carry it along further into the offensive zone. Poke checked away there by Curtis on the center blue line, so Maine will come back and now send it back across to neutral ice. Peltier fans on her headman feet up along the far side right. Finds the forehand stick here of Dunbar. Goal skates into the zone, top right circle, looking to get one in front. Redirected wide. McManus now to clean it up on the corner. McManus angles it along. Dunbar trying to get it further behind the net. Out to the far wing, Turner. Turner trying to get it for McManus. Instead, it hops over the stick of Howren out to the near side. Inside 2 minutes to play. Wildcats up 2-0 now. Chapman was first, and then it was Jonna Curtis sending a wrister home down low on the circle. Cleared back to center, and now here come the Black Bears up along the far side right. Backhanded along and gloved down by Cashin.
Vanasova coming up the right wing. Takes the deflection, and she got the backhand in on Cashin, and Cashin in position flashes the glove and makes the save to preserve the Wildcat lead. But Vanasova's had a couple chances here in the period, but Cashin has been up to par in net so far.
Glove side left of Cashin, 1:39 to go here in the period. Rob will have the out-of-town scoreboard for you, the calendar, and a recap here of 40 minutes of play coming up during the Bud Light intermission show in just a few moments. On the corner, now the circle on the far wing. Schlegel backhanding it along, trying to get it up and out. Taken down by the Black Bears, carried along. Behind the back feed, no one there except for the Wildcats. And up along the far right, Taylor got it across. Bouncing puck all the way through the middle and got it over for Prowse for a moment. Comes out here for Vanasova here on the corner. Wildcats and Taylor, nice job here in the main zone. Up along the near side right, it's going to be lifted back to center. Peltier on the pickoff. Peltier out to the far side right. A wrister from atop the circle is blocked down by Jackson. 17 shots for New Hampshire, 12 for the Black Bears as Maine tries to force a shot in with Hutchison. Comes out to the corner on the far wing. Off the end wall, Hutchison carries it along down low on the circle. Back up to the point, Colton, blocked down by the Cats. Here comes Chapman again. She likes his left side. Chapman now looking, and now she'll pivot back atop the left circle. Gets it over for Fedeski. Fedeski lifts it along through the corner out to the far side. Here's Curtis now. Jonna now reverses it back. Played up ice for Chapman over on the corner on the far wing. Taves coming over for some trailer help over on the far side with inside 20 seconds to go here in the period. Behind the net further, centering feed. Picked off here by the Black Bears, and now back across the middle, Tufts. Tufts has some speed now with 7 to go. Cats are going to get whistled here for the penalty. Curtis, I believe, on a trip. Well, it's going to be a hook here across the blue line on the carry ahead. So now 3.7 to go in the period. Cats are going to go down a skater.
Man, not the penalty you want to give up right there. You have a 2-goal lead, and Tufts is coming up the ice 1-on-3. And Curtis comes up from behind and just takes her down. She had two defensemen in front of her that were in good position to slow down Tufts, so not a penalty you want to give up there, as momentum's on your side, and Maine will take it, though, as they look to get back in this game as we move into the third period.
Fedeski clears it as we sound the horn through 40 minutes of play. Wildcats up 2-0 against arch rival Maine. One more timeout from our second period rotation. We'll do that now. You're listening to Wildcat Hockey from Learfield.
the end of the second period. UNH shots 20, Maine 12. Thank you.
Radio in the third period, and here with the call is Nate Bridges.
Stacy along the near side left neutral zone, trying to get it back into New Hampshire territory. Here's Stacy along the left side, drops it back for Gilmore. Outside left circle, Stacy again. Remember the power play for Maine, shot off the pipe on the far side, trying to redirect it home. Over on the far wing was Catherine Tufts. Outside right circle now, played by the Black Bears in the zone to the left of us. Tufts now on the corner, back up to the point, played at the point by the Black Bears and by Valentin. Down low on the right circle, through the middle, angled off the near half wall, and it comes back to center on the clear. Wildcats almost had an opportunity here along the right side as Taves was trying to skate up to Gilmore. Gilmore blew a tire, lost her edge. Taves had some room on the right side, but there to clean it up there was Valentin. She regathers it now and tries to get it back over for Gilmore on the near side left. Maine having a tough time here gathering some traction here on the fresh sheet of ice at the beginning stages here of the third period of play. 2-0, Wildcats on top. Two tallies there in that second period. Up along the left side, Valentin. She gets it back across the middle, hops off the stick here of Murray, out to the far side wing, controlled over there by the Black Bears, this time on the right point. Outside right circle, backhanded along. Trying to work their way in along the far wing, lifted along, bouncing puck in front. Vinasova was there, and it's going to be cleared back by the Wildcats and Devin Taylor.
Yeah, Vinasova's definitely been the best player for Maine out on the ice through two periods. Five shots off her stick, and she is a strong, speedy player, and she's caused some disruption in front of the Wildcat net a couple times today, but Hilly Cashin has been ready for her to this point.
John is going to come out of the box in 7 seconds right now on this power play for the Maine Black Bears. We're 2 minutes deep here into the third period of play. Up along the left side, Wildcats try to play it along on the circle. Here's Peltier getting it up ice. Here comes Curtis out of the box. Breakaway opportunity. Jonna sends one in, and she scores! Fresh out of the penalty box, Jonna Curtis with a home run feed to the center blue line walks her way in, and she makes it a 3-0 game.
And always, that's why they call it the vulnerable minute right there. The Wildcats get possession, and they find Curtis streaking out of the box.
Watch this
all
little
alone.
Kick right here.
Makes
Whoop.
A great little deke and got the main goaltender and Jackson to commit. She went down into the butterfly, and the rest has been told. Curtis able to lift it up with the wrister over Jackson, and the Wildcats extend their lead to 3-0, and now a change in net for Maine as well.
We'll get to that in just a moment. Wildcats up 3-0. Second goal of the contest for Curtis. Up along the far wing, backhanded along. Rowe trying to get it along further for Chapman. Finds its way in front of Cashin. Backhanded along by Revkin. Off ice, Curtis trying to play it once again. Up along the far side left, Jonna into the zone. Has Taves on her right. Centers it up and a score! Jonna across the middle. Gets it over for line mate and Carly Taves. It's now a 4-0 game.
And the Wildcats offense all of a sudden buzzing off of the faceoff. They keep the pressure on, and the goal scorer with two says, I'm going to give up the puck here a little bit. The cross ice pass to Taves, and Taves notches her fifth goal of the season. And the Wildcats now have opened the doors on this one, 4-0 the score.
We'll get to that goaltender in just a moment for the Maine Black Bears facing that one shot. We'll get to that at the next whistle up along the near corner. Played here by the Wildcats, Dunbar. Behind the net, McManus. She now swivels back to the corner further. Back up to the point, Revkin. Revkin gets it down low further again, McManus. Also there on the near wing is Turner. Turner couldn't quite handle the puck. Cleared back to the point. Jakes couldn't quite hold it. Now it comes back onto the stick here of Turner at the center logo. Out to the far wing, now in the circle, snapping it wide was Turner again, looking for a bounce off the end wall was McManus, out to the corner on the far wing, up to the point, Fedeski. Fedeski now sends one in, and it's sticked aside. Out to the corner on the near wing, through the corner to the near half wall now. Played here by the Maine Black Bears, Hutchison, through the center line, gets it out to Jakes, or just beyond Jakes, on the near wing. And now the Wildcats will cycle behind, around, and now a bouncing pass back through neutral ice out of the way of Hazlitt as she couldn't quite handle. Hazlitt now crashing the end wall, trying to take control of the loose puck. Up along the corner on the near wing, backhanded along out to the far side, and now it's played by Hazlitt again on the cleanup. Back up to the point, Cats try to thread the needle in. Blocked down by the Black Bears. Pribilova now along the near wing, carried along into the zone. Through the corner on the near side. behind the net. Hazlett was there for the Cats, trying to backhand it along there for the Black Bears was Pribilova again. Outside right circle, trying to send one in. Kicked aside there by Fedeski. She lifts it along through center. We have inside 16 to go, Rob. It's a 4-0 game. Cats really came out of the gates firing as we get an icing whistle against the Wildcats.
Yeah, and if you really look at it, you take the timing in that second period where the Wildcats scored the two goals to close out the second period, and their first two here in the third. Wildcats have scored four goals over the last 8 minutes of play. So Wildcats, the first 35 minutes or so of this one were sort of sluggish for both teams, but the Wildcats have been able to play themselves out of it with some nice play, especially from the top line in Jonna Curtis.
Along the near side, right, carried along. Maria Fujimagari in goal here for the Black Bears, a senior 5'10 out of Markham, Ontario. Five games played on the season. In her career, 28 games played, 6-8-2, a 3.37 goals against. I think she played in a contest here last year in relief as well.
Not a nice welcoming for her and net either. First shot she sees goes by her. Not enough time to just get comfortable out there on the ice.
Now to the far side left. Cats into the zone again. Here's Curtis sending one along and trying to send it in for the Cats was Radatovich. That was from midair. And now the Wildcats come back. Play a little bit of D as sending it along the near wing into the zone there with Sekundiak. Out to the corner now on the far wing. Black Bears carry it along. Over there is Tufts behind the net further. Played here by the Black Bears. Kundiak there. Comes out to the corner through the near circle. The Cats will clear it up and out of the zone. Curtis tried to get it over Radatovich over on the far side left. Tuzo is going to try to clean up a loose puck here to the near half wall as well. She gets met here on the near wing wall with Herman. Out to the far side. Back ended along by Hutchison. Comes back to neutral ice center again. Just beyond the center red line. Schlegel sends it along. And a full change here for Coach Witt. Hutchison will now play it back to neutral ice, trying to get it out to the opposite wing on the far side right. He's trying to streak it up with Jakes, and we'll get a whistle-stopping play with 14:14 to go, an icing whistle against Maine. We'll step aside. This is Wildcat Hockey from Learfield.
Home run passes down the ice, and they'll have to continue to do that here if they want to try to make this interesting over the last 14 minutes of the game.
Cats clear. Fujimagari comes out to play. She leaves it off for Hummel. Out to the corner on the near wing. There to play is Motto. Inside 14 to go here in this one. Don't forget the men coming up later on as the Wildcats down in South Bend. Pre-game coming your way at half past the 6 o'clock hour. Shot from the point, knocked down by Cashin, comes out to the corner on the far side. Cleared back to the point, not up and out. Wildcats get a skate on it over on the far side with Howard. On top of the main line, they try to get it back through neutral ice. Trying to carry it along there was Venisova. Back up to the point on the far side right. Cross ice feed. Looking down low with Pribilova down low on the near side left circle. It's going to be cleared back through center.
Yeah, Pribilova had Venisova streaking toward the net, but the pass was just out of reach for her to make a connection on the little give and go.
Hazlett couldn't control for the Wildcats, so back to chase it down is Gilmore in her own zone. Gilmore tries to backhand it along. She does so. Up ice off the skate of Curtis. Jonna now retreats back into her own zone. Now looks for some full head of steam up into the zone. Curtis has Taves on her right. Curtis gets it over for Taves, and Taves couldn't quite handle the feathered pass across the slot.
Yeah, Curtis got under that puck a little bit, and it was bouncing in the air as it came to Taves, but Curtis still with the nice setup to try to get Taves her second goal of the game.
Gilmore behind the net, gets it out to the circle on the far wing in her own zone, looking for an angled up feed up ice out to the far wing with Brigham. Wildcats and Taves got a handle of it and sent it further back into the main zone. Wildcats will get a change, and everybody will change it up here. The top two forwards here on this PK with McManus and Turner. Out on the ice, Peltier alongside Schlegel. back on the line for UNH with now 12 to go on the PK. Peltier tries to strip it away on the carry up ice behind the net by Maine. Up along the near wing, Motto tries to force it further along. Motto on the goal line extended, centers it up, and a shot goes high and wide. Sekundiak on the drive. Cats get back to full strength, angled along McManus. She tried to skate along with it with Dunbar across center ice. Inside 12 to go, played over there on the far wing. Just in front of the Wildcat bench as it comes back to the Wildcat decor, and here's Schlegel, D to D out to the far side left with Peltier. Icing will be whistled here against the Wildcats, and we'll stop play with 11:37 to go. 4-0 Wildcats on top of the Black Bears here in the third period.
The Wildcat penalty kill has been impressive this afternoon, now killing off five Maine power plays, and seems like Maine's had their best opportunities right off of that faceoff they've been able to set up, but once the Wildcats have been able to get the puck out of the zone, they've really cramped down on the ice and have had some real solid kills and has limited the opportunities for Maine.
Rebound left out in front by Cashin. Tuff's got a shot off. Thought that one just crossed the line here on the near wing, but I guess the Black Bears kept it in on top of the blue line, so they had an opportunity to carry it along further. Instead, it's redirected back to center. Gets behind Dunbar. McManus also trying to play it along here as well. Tuff's with control. She snaps it back over to the center line. Maine can't quite carry it along. Dunbar out to the far side left, and we get a whistle and an offside call with 11:06 to go here in the third period. Wildcats up 4-0 on an offensive explosion at the end of the second period and carried over to the beginning portions of the third. Two goals for the Wildcats within 23 seconds. Curtis and Taves here in this third period of play. Out on the far circle, played by the Black Bears. Behind the net, cycling behind and around out to the far wing, backhanded along by Herman. Comes back to center. Wildcats send it right back on into the main end. Black Bears play beyond their netminder in Fujimagari, who comes in relief of Jackson. 41 minutes, 52 seconds, 16 stops for Carly Jackson, as we will get a whistle back in the New Hampshire end, and an icing will go against the Black Bears, this time stopping play with 10.5 to go in the third.
Yeah, and I think Jackson obviously getting pulled after giving up three goals in this one, but I thought she didn't play too badly in net. She was definitely under fire a couple times in period number two and held her own in the crease, but I think a mixture of, you know, the last night giving up four goals as well as three here tonight, and it was just coach decided it's time to give her a little rest here and save her up for the rest of the season.
So here's Tuzos, Radatovic, and Curtis for the Wildcats. Curtis skates along the near side right wing, trying to carry it along through the hashes on the right side. Ribolova comes away with it, sends it up into neutral ice, hops over the stick of Fedeski. Howren cleaned it up, out to the far wing, Radatovic. Front of the Wildcat bench, Curtis over there as well, beyond the far blue line, comes back to Fedeski on a feed over from the right side, left side rather, with Howren. Wildcats and Curtis. Curtis now tries to get it out to the wing on the right side, Tuzos. Maine doing a nice job forcing it along into the offensive end. Curtis backhands it along, gets it out to the corner on the far wing, and there is Howren trying to send it along the far left neutral. Sends it in on net, though. Wildcats would have gotten the icing whistle against them right there, but it found its way in towards Fujimagari. Behind the net, carried along here by the Black Bears. Hutchison out to the far right circle in her own end. An outlet feed out to the far side right. Into the zone, Maine skates with it, trying to split the defenders along. Cashin trying to make the stop on the initial bid. She left one out in front, a streaking Maine skater up along the left side, and Jake's got one in as well. Cashin up to the challenge, up along the far side right neutral. Wildcats try to play it along their far side left now. Instead, the Black Bears come away with it. Back through center, Motto. Snaps it out to the far side right on a diagonal feed. Save made by Cashin on the send ahead. Comes out along the near half wall. Cats try to lift it along the near glass. Two of each sweater battle for a loose puck along the near wing. Tufts tries to get it back to the point. Instead, the Cats on the takeaway. McManus will play it along the near half wall back into the main zone, but not for long. Motto gets it up ice. Here's Stacy. Feeds it out to the far wing. Sekundiak centering feed. Tufts. She gets it through some traffic and a save made by Cashin again. Back up to the far right point. Bounces along. Cleaned up here by Turner. Turner now with a short feed, picked off here by Herman as she lifts it back on into the New Hampshire end.
Yeah, Maine picking up the offensive pressure here over the last 2 or 3 seconds on the 3-on-2. Sekundiak had the good look on the quick touch passes, but again, Hillary Cashin in good position as she has been all afternoon to make a save.
Wildcats with some tenacious pressure here in front of the Black Bear net. Curtis tried to center it up for Taves. Cleared back through center, and here comes Hutchison along the near side left. Has some daylight, but it's sticked aside by the Wildcats' Cashin. Follow-up opportunity on a wraparound. Broken up, and now the Cats try to clear it back with Taves. Taves got it back to neutral ice, and a hand pass will be whistled against the Cats. Just inside 8 minutes to play in the third period. Cats in control with a 4-0 lead. We'll step aside. This is Wildcat Hockey from Learfield. Power play now. Wildcats without a power play tally in this one. 0 of 3 coming into this man advantage. In front of the penalty boxes, there's Jonna Curtis trying to come away with it. She skates back, looking for the top of the circle. Taves there as well. Jonna comes away with it outside left circle. 1:38 to go here on this Unitil power play. Unitil energy for life. Inside the blue line, here's Peltier. Peltier gets it out to the far side left, played here by Curtis. Down low on the goal line extended. Taves looking for Schlegel. She couldn't quite bury the puck. She had all kinds of open mesh there in front of her, and now it's lifted along, kept in here by Schlegel at the point. Outside right circle, Hazlitt trying to thread one across the middle, broken up. Taves was the sniper in front. It comes back to Peltier. 1:12 to go here on this Unitil power play. 4-0 Wildcats on top. Peltier gets it down low to the circle. Lifting one in is Schlegel off the shoulder of Fujimagari, and it comes along to the point, and here's Peltier. Cleaned up and cleared out by the Black Bears. Length of the ice, Hummel did the clearance bid there for Maine.
Wildcats with moving the puck well along the blue line to set up some shots with their forwards, but Fujimagari able to make two saves there for the Cats.
Comes back across the middle. Here come the Cats with a breakout opportunity. Shot and a score. A power play goal for Fedeski makes it a 5-0 game. Cats in control of this one late in the third.
And Fedeski there just sneaks behind the main defense. When you're on the penalty kill, you wouldn't think you'd let a forward sneak in, but with the 4-0 lead, you're being extra aggressive offensively. And Fedeski just hanging out the blue line, takes the long pass, and she'll knock home her 6th goal of the season for the junior out of Ontario.
So 5-0 is our score. Inside 6.5 to go here in the third period. Wildcats in control of this one. Fedeski tries to chase it down to the corner just after the goal tally a moment ago. Comes back through center. Maine trying to chase down. Sekundiak plays it and cycles it behind her own netminder. Fujimagari comes back over for Turner. And now here's Dunbar. Dunbar down low on the far near side circle route. Back up to the point. Here's Fedeski. Fedeski gets it over for Turner again. Turner through some traffic. Sent it across the middle. McManus was there, so too Dunbar, just in front of Fujimagari. Inside 6 minutes to go here in the third period. Goal line extended left. Wildcats behind the net now. Backhanded along. Fedeski, top of the right circle, sends it wide. Fujimagari got a blocker on it, guided it out to the corner. Now it's cleared back by the Black Bears. And now a breakout opportunity back the other way. Couldn't quite gather the full head of steam. There was Tufts. Looked to peel back to the bench. Looked like she was out of gas there, Rob.
And, you know, Maine Tufts is a very tough skater. She has a lot of speed, and she's had a couple chances this afternoon, but maybe just a little running out of gas here late in this one. 120 minutes of hockey in less than 24 hours.
Out to the right circle, working their way in are the Black Bears, and it sails high and wide on the bid from the far side right. Trying to send it along there for the Black Bears. I believe it was Jakes. Back through center, comes back to the Maine Black Bears through their blue line out to the far wing. Kisara tried to control it. Now here's Jakes again, backhanding it along, trying to get it out to the near side wing. Herman trying to get it over further to the point area with Washer. Washer now looking to Lumber away back through center into the offensive end. Skates out to the far side right. Tried to force it across center. She gets met up over there with the Wildcats and Radatovic. And now back the other way, Curtis again. Curtis between the dots. She lifts one home and she scores! Curtis with a hat trick lifts it upstairs. It's now a 6-0 game.
What an afternoon for Jonna Curtis. She gets the hat trick, all fancy goals. Just great stick handling by the senior coming into today's game. 13 points away from 100 on her career, and now she's at 9, the senior, getting the job done this afternoon for New Hampshire.
4:31 to go here in the third period. Jonna with the goal. And now back along the far side right, Vinasova again carries it along. Between the dots, angled along out to the corner on the near wing, back up to the point. Controlled at the point here by Arnold. Getting one between the circles again. Backhanding it along for the Black Bears is Vinasova. Comes out to the circle on the near wing. Cats clear it up and out of the zone. Doing so there was Taves. Trying to get it back over for Chapman. Out to the far side right. Cats play it out to the corner on the near side. Check that Black Bears out to the near side left. Jakes trying to lift it along further. Inside four to go. Cats come away with it. Now here's Curtis again. Curtis outside right circle looking in front. Try to get it over for Chapman, and Fujimagari will cover it up, and it's whistle dead. Inside four to go. 3:45 to go in the third period. Wildcats up 6-0 over the Black Bears. This is Wildcat hockey from Learfield.
Up by Fedeschi, but she's really grown into a huge offensive player this year, something that we've been waiting for a while, but what a great leader she's been so far this season in the growth of this team.
Hauer and Fedeschi. Fedeschi sends one wide. Inside the blue line, here's Turner, sending one wide off from the point, a wrister from the point. Here's McManus now out to the corner on the far side. It's really a shame, Rob, that we really didn't get to see Jonna with her full potential with two collarbone injuries. From the point, a shot is held onto by Fujimagari. Bid taken there by Howren on the left point. 1:29 to go on the Unitil power play for the Wildcats. 1:50 to go here in regulation. Yeah, those two injuries in her freshman sophomore years really
just... Because I remember when she came in here, right, at the beginning of her freshman year, we saw that promise of being the next big offensive star, but those injuries just really slowed her down big time. But it's nice to see in her senior year she's finally been able to put together a full season to this point.
Along the near side left, Curtis tries to thread it along. I think it was Blake Bolden who rode her into the wall on that first collarbone injury for Boston College, and then the second one was a fluky injury during practice over in Dover after she came back from her freshman year injury. Back up to the point, here's a slapper and a score! Peltier from inside the blue line sends one home on the power play. It is now 7-0 with inside a minute and a half to go.
And how this game has changed, Nate. I mean, we've talked about it multiple times, but the first 35 minutes, the offensive futility on both sides. And the Wildcats then finally seem to flip a switch. And you never like to see a team just flip a switch and get into that kind of habit. But this afternoon, it's worked for them over the last basically 24 minutes of this one. The Wildcats have put 7 goals on the board.
Third goal of her career for Peltier on a slapper from the point. 1:15 to go here in the third period.
Nice to see the Wildcats put 2 power play goals together here. As the game has gone on, I think it really seemed that the power play was what really got their offense going, especially in the second period. They had 2 power plays that they didn't capitalize on, but they were able to move the puck and generate some solid scoring opportunities, and then they were able to take that and turn that into some better play in the 5-on-5, and I think that's helped the Wildcats offensively here this afternoon.
1 minute to go here in the third period. Wildcats and Tuzos trying to force it along into the main zone. Played out to the corner on the opposite side. Rowe over there for New Hampshire. Looking for a headman feed. Comes back onto the forehand stick of Rowe. Gets it up ice for Taylor. 40 seconds to go here in this one. Out to the near side left. Carried along by Stacy. Sends it across the slot. Back up to the point. Held onto by the Black Bears. Here's a slapper from straight up. Inside 25 seconds to go here in this one, and a hit along the near wall. Penalty coming against the Maine Black Bears. And you saw, I didn't see which Wildcat went down, but the helmet went right up against the glass. And whoever that white skater is here on the white sweater skater here on the near wing, it's a little slow to get up.
Looks like Nate, it's Hannah Tuzos, as we have the athletic trainer coming out on the ice and Teresa Venisova going off to the penalty box, and actually might even be surprising seeing her just go to the penalty box on that play, something you don't want to see late in the game, especially with a 7-goal lead. And the freshman forward for New Hampshire, Tuzos, up on her feet and skating gingerly off the ice, maybe even possibly favoring that shoulder. She's going to go right down the runway into the locker room. We'll hope she's okay. 2 minutes will be the call on a boarding penalty in New Hampshire now with yet another power play to close this one out.
To the corner on the near side. Out to the far side right, cleared along by the Black Bears of center. 10 seconds to go in this one. So the Wildcats put together a 5-goal third period. A 4-point effort by Jonna Curtis and the first career shutout for Hillary Cashin. Wildcats blank the Black Bears by a final score of 7-0.
And the response from the Wildcats, Nate, this afternoon is something you like to see when a game's not maybe going your way early on. You stay with the plan. You get stronger as the game goes on. And it was the Jonna Curtis show who really got this game going. 3 goals and an assist for the senior captain that led the way to this Wildcats 7-0 win.
One more break from that third period rotation. We will take that now. You are listening to Wildcat Hockey from Learfield.
stopping by and have a safe travel. Have a good night.